I'm going to refer you, I'll get the name for you, and then I'll
In the
let
field that I
you
work
guys
in,
know.
dealing with
Yeah.
breast cancer, patients are obviously very anxious. They're worried they have cancer. And so, I think that anything I can do to sort of educate my patients and to advocate for my patients, I'll do it. I think it's so important. I just see that my role as a doctor is more than just, writing a prescription and sending a patient on their way. It's also looking at it from a community perspective as well. And I think that's the only way you're going to be able to attack a problem. African American women are still have higher mortality rates. And we used to think it was just an issue of access to treatment and education. We know that's part of it, but we now see that there might be some genetic issues in pl that play a role too. I'd like to see more progress made in terms of the treatment for breast cancer in African American women.
My mother had didn't have breast cancer, she had cervical cancer, but even though she ultimately passed, she was fortunate enough to have a very dedicated doctor. And I think that had an impact on me, even though she was being treated while I was very young. Even though she was educated and she also was a nurse, she was someone who was very quite busy taking care of her family. Unfortunately, she didn't have the time or didn't take the time to take care of herself. And that's something that I try to, emphasize in my conferences and when I give talks, that it is important. You have to take care of yourself first before you can take care of your family. It's very easy for all of us to sort of get caught up in our own lives and our own problems, but my patients keep me grounded because I think that, the determination that they have, facing chemo, facing surgery, facing radiation, and they keep going and they just have an amazing attitude. That's what keeps me going.